Today I want to show you how you can play practically any game with just an eye tracker and software mill mouse. It has mouse cursor and game camera control with eyes or head tracking. It has voice commands and even support for facial gestures is coming soon. It's amazing and it is absolutely free. So let me show you how you can set up a gaming profile. Go to the Profiles tab. I already have one profile called Default with everything I need for accessing my desktop. Let us copy that. We'll call this new profile Game Keyboard Simple. Let's switch to this new profile so we can edit it to our liking. Then I'll go to the Window tab and make the Mill Mouse Bar black. The overlay with shortcuts looks better and less intrusive this way. Now we're over at the Input tab, and here's where we're gonna set up some voice commands. Click the cog wheel and in the new window click the plus sign. Here we're going to give the command a name and assign a key to it. In this case we want to toggle the shift key on and off for when we want to sprint. So we choose the option hold down the keys in the drop down menu. Now let's repeat the process for the control key which we need to toggle on and off to be able to crawl. Oh, I forgot. Let's do the same for the spacebar, which we need to be able to hold down. I mean toggle on, to aim a jump. Now let's assign a key press to eye blinks. Currently it's a bit slow, or rather you can make it faster by increasing the overall click interval speed, but that's not what we want and it still doesn't get responsive enough. But don't worry, I'm in contact with a developer and he's constantly implementing feature requests and he says this is definitely on the list. For now, it does the job in this kind of chill game. Otherwise, Project Iris is a good alternative that handles this better right now, although it is paid. Enough about that. Make sure that the boxes, click when you speak into the microphone, as well as click when you close your eyes are both checked. Now click the cog wheel for the eye blinks function, and in the new box, choose select a key in the drop-down menu. Then go ahead and choose spacebar, cause we want to jump quickly when we blink. Now it's time for creating the eye tracking overlay. This takes a bit more time, but you don't have to do this every time, and you can repurpose old profiles and quickly edit them to suit new games, or make edits to a copy if you want to keep the original intact. And the gamepad emulation in Mill Mouse is getting better and better. Going forward, I think I will use the gamepad emulation, because that is probably more consistent between games, and you don't have a full keyboard with tons of keys that might potentially be used by this or that game. But the developer is still improving the gamepad emulation, so I'll probably wait and do a tutorial later this year. Okay, let's get to it then and create the shortcuts. Go to the Shortcuts tab. In the right-hand list scroll down to the bottom and highlight the first entry under the separate window section. That is because we don't want the gaming shortcuts stacked together with the rest of the shortcuts in the disappearing Mill Mouse bar. Now click the plus sign on the left side of the window. In the new window, first you will give the shortcut a name. Then in the section called Type, choose Shortcut Key from the drop-down menu. In the drop-down menu called Key, select the key you want to activate when looking at the shortcut, and in this case it's Q. Under Action, choose Hold down the keys and make sure to check the box underneath that says Press the keys only when gazing at the shortcut button.
Attention!
If you don't check the box, it will be a toggle on and off function. If you instead choose the action called Press the keys, then it will only press the key quickly once no matter if you keep looking at the shortcut. I've honestly never needed the press keys function. My experience in Project Iris was that many games didn't even recognize the extremely quick single press function. Do note that keeping your gaze on the shortcut as we have set it up now doesn't result in quick repeated presses, but instead a hold. The kind of turbo key presses we might want sometimes is coming as a function in Mill Mouse later on. Now click the speed tab and select a custom key press. We want immediate reaction when we gaze at it, so pull it all the way to the right where it says short. We have now created our first shortcut key, but where in the world is it, you might ask? In order for it to appear on the display, make sure that you have highlighted the first entry under separate window on the left and that on the right, the custom shortcut in question is highlighted. Then just press the right pointing arrow and that will move it from our library of available shortcuts and into the current shortcuts, those we want to use when we're in this profile. Voila, there it is on the left side of the screen. Before we move and resize this shortcut and the rest of them, highlight Q under the separate window section and then press the copy button. We'll change the name of the copy to E as in Aaron, and then we click the edit button and just change the key to E. it will retain the speed settings of the original shortcut. Repeat the process for the F key. I'll fast forward a bit. We're not finished yet, but let's move and resize the ones we have created anyways. I think that looks good. Now let's create the shortcuts for the arrow keys, which we need to walk around in the game. Copy one of the shortcuts we created, and let's edit it to trigger the next key we want. Let's start with the up arrow, and I'm gonna create a symbol for this with two opposing side slash signs. In the key section, choose up arrow key from the drop-down menu. Now we want to toggle forward walk on and off. So from the drop-down menu called action, we will choose hold down the keys and then untick the box that says press the keys only when gazing at the shortcut button. So now that this is finished, we create new shortcut copies and edit them to correspond to the remaining three arrow keys. These arrow keys will have a hold action instead of toggle. I'll fast forward till everything is created, and we will then resize and position them to our liking. Now we're moving and resizing the shortcuts to our liking. In a moment, I'll be showing this in action with some gameplay from the new indie game Little Kitty, Big City. Give this video a like if you found it useful and consider hitting the subscribe button. I hope you will have a sunny and calm day, just like in the game. Until next time, friends. You